tariff is applicable to 90% of goods from the six other members of ASEAN. For example, Philippines, Indonesia, Singapore. From 2015, zero tariff is applicable to 90% of goods from the four new members of ASEAN. For example, Myanmar, Laos, etc. In part four, we are going to talk about how to manage health risks. We'd like to introduce three real cases in China in order to make you aware of what had happened in China during the past years in the anti-tax avoidance practice. Xinjiang case occurred in 2008 when the China-Barbados tax treaty had not been revised. Based on the old treaty, China has no right to levy withholding tax when a Barbados company transfers its shares in China subsidiary. However, in this case, Company A transfers its shares in Company B, to Company C. Since Company A failed to present the tax certificate to verify it is a Barbados written company, Company A is denied to enjoy the China-Barbados tax treatment. Therefore, a 10% withholding tax was levied on the transaction. In Chongqing case, both Company D and Company E are Singapore companies. Company D transferred its shares in Company E to Company G. Because investment Company D was liable for withholding tax on capital gains from the sales, because the investment holding in Company F was the sole activity of Company E. Jiangsu case is somehow similar to Chongqing case. The investor disposed of its shares in Company I, which is a Hong Kong company, to an unrelated US company. The tax authorities concluded that in determining how the transaction should be treated for China tax purposes, the Hong Kong company should be disregarded because it lacked substance. It did not have employees. It did not have assets, liabilities, or real operating activities. The tax authority determined the investor be taxed as if it had directly disposed of its 49% of shares in the Chinese company. As far as the transfer pricing is concerned, there are two graphs in this page of slides. The first one indicates the amount of transfer pricing investigation cases. The second one indicates the amount of the tax collected from the transfer pricing investigations. You see, the cases dropped significantly from the year of 2003. While in the meantime, the tax collected from the transfer pricing investigation rise dramatically, which demonstrates China tax authority paid more and more attention to the quality of the transfer pricing investigation. The fundamentals of the transfer pricing consists of compliance, enforcement, risk management, advance pay pricing arrangement. The factors of compliance include disclosure, documentation, and others. For the enforcement, you may need to be aware of who to investigate, what to investigate, and how to investigate. A self-assessment is a good way to manage risks, and the APA could further reduce the relevant risks. The graph on the left indicating a common arrangement of MNCs. Company A sent its employee, Mr. X, to work in Company A's Chinese subsidiary, Company B. The legal employment contract is sent between Company A and Mr. X. Therefore, Mr. X's salary is paid by Company A. The reimbursement is made between Company A and Company B. Then, would this trigger PE concern? Permanent establishment is a common concept when dealing with the international tax issues. And whether it could trigger the PE concern? This would depend on the answers to these questions on the right. Whether individual works under control and supervision of Company B. Whether Company B bears risks and responsibilities of individuals' day-to-day work. Whether individual performs any other functions on behalf of his legal employer for other entities. Whether individual's work is reviewed and appraised by Company B. Whether payment for individual takes form of recharge of employment costs to host the entity without markup. Taking all these answers into consideration, we then can tell whether it has created a PE in China. Individual income tax implications on the international assignment also need to be considered. If the service does not create a PE in China, there would be no IIT liabilities for the individual. However, if the service creates a PE in China, the individual shall be liable for Chinese IIT for their presence in China. But what if we change the arrangement to an employment basis? That is to say, an employment contract is signed between Company B and Mr. X, or a dual employment contract is arranged. Under this arrangement, individual is liable for IIT for its Chinese employment income. Company B shall withhold and pay the IIT on a monthly basis. Tax internal control is an essential part of an enterprise's internal control system. Under the current circumstances, the tax environment are being more and more challenged for the MNCs. To take precautions against the tax risks, foreign investors shall adjust and upgrade their tax internal controls. In our practice, the following aspects need to be considered. First, tax department. Set up a tax department independent from other functions to specialize the tax review, tax compliance, and tax planning, and public relationship work. Perform in-depth tax compliance review or tax health check every 2 or 3 years with the assistance from external tax experts. Draw the international tax management guidelines and emphasize